begin my session, my pranam to the Holy Triune, Sri Ramakrishna, Sharada Mahi and Swami Vivekananda. I welcome all the dignitaries, all the students, college faculty members.
To win over Mount Everest. If you talk, yes, you can clap, and there is nothing called half clap. Either you clap or you don't clap, right? So this makes no sense if it doesn't make a sound. If you name somebody like Anand Kumar, who had to give away his studies because of the poverty, but he takes charge of his life and goes on to start an institute called Super 30, which is probably the only institute which, not in just MSET, in IIT, they get 100% enrollment. He takes 30 students without fees, and he ensures that all of them get into an institute like IIT. If you take, yes, Ravi Shankarji, please, quickly. If you take the name of Jamshedji Tata, who was there on a ship from Yokohama to Vancouver, and incidentally meets Vivekananda there, they both talk, and Jamshedji told that, I am going to explore about steel. I want to bring the technology of steel to India. And then Vivekananda suggests him to do something about that, the technology and the science of West can be brought to the Asiatic wisdom of India, and that will be a great combination. And today we have an Indian Institute of Sciences, which is a pioneer in research in India because of Vivekananda. If you take many such names who changed their life, and not only individuals, for example, Japan was completely devastated in Second World War, but they took charge of their country and soon raised to glory. Similarly, Israel, similarly, Singapore. If you see all these lives, whether you're the girl who lost leg and then took charge of her life and changed, today she has covered more than 6 mountains, all the highest peaks in the world. 2011, her accident happened. 2013, she scaled Mount Everest, and after that, 5 more mountains. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. At the time when Indians were feeling despondent, somebody took charge. I will raise the army. I will create a way to get rid of Britishers. He took charge. That's why he's called Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Netaji, fixed. Dashrath Maji took charge. The man cut the mountain. Can you imagine? 20 years? 20 years single-handedly with a hammer and chisel. The man just broke through the mountain. Dashrath Maji. And today this is called Dashrath Maji Mark. Yes, I told about Jamshedji Tata, Indian Institute of Sciences, and much more contribution to our Indian industries. Next. Yes, this man, if you can identify, his name is Babar Ali. In a small village of Paschim Bengal, where there was no education, especially for the girls, no education was there. He could have become a very good crybaby. What can I do for the society? There is no money. People are not interested to send girl child for education, but he took charge. Getting inspired by Vivekananda, read a small book of Vivekananda from Sri Ramakrishna Math there, and took charge. He became the youngest headmaster in the world. Today, in his school, there are more than 1,000 students studying. And school is completely AC because there is no roof. But he is called on world over for platforms to speak. He is the youngest headmaster. And it's a pity that we in India could not recognize him. It took a BBC London to recognize his effort. Next. Anand Kumar, I told you, Super 30. He took charge of life. Not only his own life, but he is helping hundreds like himself to get into IITs. All these people he teaches free of cost. And he ensures they all get into IIT. Next. Anna Hazare, a driver in military, was about to commit suicide. Just by chance, gets his hand on a book on Vivekananda. Reads that, changes his mind. Why should I die? I can devote this life to the society. And today, he becomes an inspiring personality. So we can go on and go on and go on. What we find common in all these people is they took charge. They took charge of their life. They did not become a complaining person. What we do commonly in our society, what we see, that we keep on giving excuses. Government is like this, or people are not supporting, or my family is not supporting, or my father is poor, or my college is like that, or I come from a small village. All these things we keep on giving excuses, but all those people, they did not give excuse. Arunima Sinha could very well said, I was carrying a ticket, but these gundas came into the train and they threw me up, and therefore I become a girl who is just looking for sympathy. But no, she took charge. So the first trait of a leader, first trait of a young leader like you is going to be, I take charge, I do not wait for people to come, I start on my own. That's the first trait of a leader. So when you are going to execute, and there is going to be a lot of discussion on that, how will you execute? It's because this is a whole month program. In your college, you will be executing some programs. Do good, be good, do good activities you will be doing. There will be problems for that. We need leaders who can carry this. And the question for the leaders is not that who will support. The leaders say, it's not about who will support me, let me see who will stop me. Let me see who will stop me. That's the mindset of a leader. So we want all of you to go from here with the mindset that let me see who will stop me. Okay. Now next. Challenge to leaders. Come. And I'm not going to talk fully about leadership. I'm just going to give you very brief ideas. One of the challenges to leader come is, I tried my best. I did everything, but I did not get the credit. And many a times, people get disheartened because they do not get credit for what they work. Now please note down the statement what I am saying. Craving for appreciation is not a leader's thought process. Craving for appreciation is not a leader's thought process. It's a typical follower's thought process. Everybody enjoys if somebody praises, there is no doubt. But if there is craving, you know, I have made the tea, the guests are there, I am serving the tea, and now I am sitting there like a beggar. Please tell how is the tea. Please tell it is good. I have cooked the food, please tell how it is. I have made the project, please tell, like a beggar, I am waiting, craving for appreciation. I have bought a new sari and now waiting for the compliments. And if nobody compliments, the same sari becomes a source of misery for me. Craving for appreciation is not a leader's thought process. So if you are leaders, I have a technique for you. I have a technique for you in case you do something with great effort, lot of honesty, with lot of hard work, you put your heart and soul and you really complete something significant, maybe in your college, your personal life or outside, and then you fail to get the recognition you deserve, then there is a technique you should do. So we'll follow this technique, all of you. Would you follow with me?
Yes.
Come on, little loudly. Would you follow with me?
Yes.
Okay, so there are three steps to that technique. To complete those three steps, I want all of you to stand up. Stand up, please. And students, my request is to students, kindly stand up. Yeah. So please follow this technique. Okay? All of you, look at me. This technique has three steps. Okay? And the step number one is this. All of you, raise your hand. Raise your hand. Step number one. Step number two is this. Turn it up 180 degree. And step number three is this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? Yes. So this is the technique you should use when nobody appreciates you. Okay? Please sit down. Thank you.